Good morning, students. Let's begin our today's class. In the chapter agriculture, today we will study about the plantation farming. So first come to know what plantation means. Plantation means on a very large area of land, especially in a hot country where tea, tobacco, cotton, etc. are grown. Now what plantation farming means? Plantation farming is a form of farming where crops are grown for the purpose of making profit. What it means? That in the plantation farming, the main intention of this type of farming is to yield very high for the purpose of sale in the market, and after the sale to get a very high profit. So we can say that it is a profit based farming. The main intention of this farming is to produce high of a good quality, then sell in the market and get a very high profit. Some of the examples of this type of farming are, the crops that are grown in farming, plantation farming, are tobacco, cotton, jute, rubber, tea, coffee, sugarcane, edible oil, etc. So these crops are grown just for the purpose of to sell in the market. These are not the food crops. We can't consume it directly. Once these crops are harvested, they are sold in the market. Then after the sale of these crops, they earn the profit. So the main purpose of this farming is to earn a profit. Then when this type of farming or the plantation farming started, when it had been developed, the plantation farming had been started in the early days of colonization. In the industrial nation of the Western Europe, who want the agricultural crops as their raw material for their manufacture or for the industries. Now what is colonization? Colonization means a land, a country or a nation who takes control over the other's land and turn those lands into different colonies. Their purpose is to roll over on those countries or on those land and just pressurize them to grow different types of crops. It had been developed in the early days when the Industrial Revolution was there. Some of the examples are that the Britishers imposed the tea gardens to India, in India and Sri Lanka, and also the rubber plantation in Malaysia. They forced them to produce such crops. Another example is there that the French people, they just established the cocoa and coffee plantation in the Cameroon and Ivory Coast. One more example is there of that the Spanish people and the Americans set up that the banana, abaca, sugar cane, they produce the abaca, the sugar cane in the country of Java. Abaca is one of the species of banana and coconut. So the Western nations impose pressurize to the countries of that are lies on the tropical or subtropical zone. They rule over, they pressurize them to grow such crops. From that time it had been started. What is the purpose of this what are the features of the plantation farming? Some of the features of plantation farming are single crops are farming on a large area. Just keep notice that the plantation farming practiced over a very large area of farm. If you have heard the word farmhouse, the people are using a word farmhouse, means they have a very large area of land in acres and or the estates, E-S-T-A-T-E-S, states are there. So they practice only a single crop instead of the multiple cropping. Single crop is grown on a very large area of crops. The purpose is to produce a very high productivity for the purpose of to get a very high profit. It is both a labor intensive and capital intensive. As we study that the intensive farming is labor based industry where large number of labor is required, and the extensive farming is machinery based. Maximum work is done by the machine. But here both are important, equally important, labor as well as the capital. Large number of labors are required as well as a huge amount to be invested on it. It has an interface of the agriculture and industry. Interface of agriculture and industry, that if you have noticed that the industries are dependent on the raw material. Without the raw material, no industry can run. As the industries are manufacturing the goods and convert it into the finished good. So they are dependent totally on the raw material. Suppose if we take the example of the car manufacturing industry. So the industry is dependent to manufacture a single piece of car. They require the iron, steel, rubber and different small and big parts of it. So they are based on the mineral, where the minerals are extracted. Some of the industries are there which are dependent on the agricultural products, agricultural crop. Agricultural crop means we can take the example of cotton industry. What the clothes we are using, we are wearing, we get from the industries or the factories are manufacturing. But those industries are dependent on the agriculture for the raw material, the cotton as their raw material. So cotton is one of the agricultural crop. It is just transported to the cotton industry where they converted the cotton into the thread and after that into the loom and then the fabric or the clothes is produced or converted into the finished product. So some of the industries are there who are dependent on the agricultural crop. Those industries are called as agro-based industries. And the Western countries are just pressurized to the subtropical and tropical countries. Those lies on the tropical or subtropical zone. They pressurize them to produce such type of agricultural crops which they carry to their country and then utilize or use as a raw material in their industries to produce the good. So here that the agricultural crop is dependent on the agriculture and industries, there is a coordination between the agricultural crop and the industry. Efficient and scientific method of cultivation. Day by day, what technology or new researches are there, the cultivation of plant is dependent on the recent developments. Special types of implements. Different new technology based implements are used in the plantation farming. Skilled but cheap and local labor. Skilled means the trained laborers are just get the job opportunity in the plantation farming. They require the skilled or the trained laborers, but they also not ready to pay a very high wages. Wages means salary. So they think to get a cheap labor, but they should be a trained one, skilled one. They are already the learned one. Worldwide marketing facility. Market also should be required. What is the demand in the market? The plantation farming dependent on it, that what demand of the market is there, they produce or grow such type of the agriculture. So here are some of the features of the plantation farming. Now what are the process that involves in the plantation farming? It involves different steps. First one, we can see that the clearing of forest. Clearing of forest. As I said that this type of farming take practice on a very large area of land or farm is there, very large farm is there. So first the forest has been cleared. They cut off the trees and put a fire on it to clear the land. Second, the preparing of land, to prepare the land. Second step is preparing the land. The different steps are there. Plugging the field, then tilting, loosening the soil, sowing the seeds, spreading the fertilizers, irrigation, irrigate the land. So different processes are there one by one in preparing the land. After that, line the road. Road facilities also there. Again telling that on a very large area of land, so it requires the transport facility also to get in the inside it, and after the crop is harvested then to take it to the market. So road facility is also required. Fourth one is the power supply. Power supply is another important factor of this process farming. That on a large area of a land, there is a supply of power also for the machines to run, as much of the work is all done by the machines also in this farming, as well as the laborers who are working on the land or on the farm. They stay back there. They have their house in on the land only. They have their family along with them. So for them, the school facility, the schools, the houses for them. Then the hospitals are also the some of the amenities of the laborers. As the laborers who are working on the land, they have their family also. So those family require the power supplies. Then for their children, the school is there for them, for their family, the house is required. And time to time, if any problem is there, they have the, they require the hospital facility also. So all these all involves in the process of in the plantation farm. Then in which part of the world it is practiced or the plantation farming is practiced? The plantation farming is practiced mostly on the tropical and subtropical zone. If it is remember, you have read about the heat zone. So in the heat zone, what is there? That tropical, then temperate zone, the tropical zone, the temperate zone, and the frigid zone. So the tropical area, 23.5 degrees north above the equator and 23.5 below the equator south. Then in those part of the world, it is mainly practiced in the countries of Indonesia, Malaysia, Sri Lanka, North, East and West of Africa, West Indies, India. These are some of the countries where the plantation farming is practiced. This is all about the plantation farming. In next class, we will talk about the mixed farming and the organic farming. Till then, thank you.